Now, we have to take out our devices, of course, because how can you do anything without devices in this day and age?
Where would we be without our phones?
We'd be in the phone booths, changing clothes. Okay, the set list is there. Well, welcome, everybody. I can't see you, but I know you're out there because I can actually hear you. So that's great. It's kind of interesting with all of this COVID stuff. The only performing I've been doing really is in front of my computer. So if I adjust your volume from time to time, please excuse me. We're going to start off with a song from Port au Port, a song I learned from Emile Benoit. Well, really, Emile Benoit and a Belgian folklorist. The story behind this song is very interesting because it took hold and people really love the song. It's called Vive la Rose, and it's a very well-known kind of children's song in France and in places where people speak French. And this woman, Isabelle Perra, who was a ballad scholar, came over and she wanted to see whether Emile had any French ballads and ballads that he sang, which he did, had numerous ones. So she went out to visit him. And so everybody was sitting around singing songs as they would, and it became her turn to sing. And she wasn't accustomed to that custom. So anyway, she had no song to sing. She was just a ballad scholar. She wasn't a ballad singer in her mind. But Emile said, well, everyone has one song they can sing. And so she sang Vive la Rose for him. And he kind of remembered hearing it from his childhood. And then he put out a version of it. And so my version is a kind of composite version between Isabel's and his. Mon ami me délaisse, oh, okay, oh, vive la rose. Mon ami me délaisse, oh, okay, oh, vive la rose. Je ne sais pas pourquoi, vive la rose et le lilas, c'est pas elle. La rose et le lilas. On dit qu'il a une eau. Oh, okay, oh, vive la rose. On dit qu'il a une eau. Oh, okay, oh, vive la rose. Peut-être plus belle que moi. Vive la rose et le lilas. Peut-être plus belle que moi. Vive la rose et le lilas. On dit qu'elle est très riche. Oh, ok, oh, vive la rose. On dit qu'elle est très riche. Oh, ok, oh, vive la rose. Vive la rose et le lilas, sans doute plus riche que moi. Vive la rose et le lilas. On dit qu'elle est malade. Oh, gay, oh, vive la rose. On dit qu'elle est malade. Oh, gay, oh, vive. Peut-être elle en mourra. Vive la rose et le lilas. Peut-être elle en mourra. Vive la rose et le lilas. Si elle meurt dimanche, oh, okay, oh, vive la rose. Si elle meurt dimanche, oh, ok, oh, vive la rose. Lundi, on l'enterrera. Vive la rose et le lilas. Lundi, on l'enterrera. Vive la rose et le vive la rose et le lilas. Moi, j'en voudrais pas. Vive la rose et le lilas. Thank you so much. Vive la rose. And for those of you who don't know the story of it, it's a girl who's lost her love, and he gets somebody else who's more beautiful, maybe more rich than she. And then she hears maybe she's sick and she's going to die. Well, if she dies on Sunday, they'll bury her on Monday, and then he'll come around on Tuesday looking for me again, and I'll say, forget it. Forget it, buddy. So that's what the story is all about. And not a very romantic story, but there you have it. This is not a very romantic story, but it's kind of a romantic story. It's about berry picking in Newfoundland. And Andy Jones often says that the only place that courting couples can find any privacy in outport Newfoundland is if they go berry picking and in on the hills. And of course, then there's a crowd of young fellas dogging after them to see what they're doing.
It's almost berry season now.
It's almost berry season now. Watch out, boys, watch out. Anyway, Ferl and Dunphy, this song is written, was made up by Peter Leonard, who couldn't actually read or write, but he was a terrific poet and made up the music for this song as well, so we understand.
An illiterate poet.
An absolutely illiterate poet, but really beautiful. Not too much. Everyone goes to school now, Sandy. I thought if I didn't give him a mic, he wouldn't be interrupting me all the time. Right?
I'm from back before
that. So am I. Anyhow, Ferlin fell in love with a girl from Pityford. He himself was belonged to Derby's Harbour, and he fell in love with a girl from Pityford. And, you know, they were going great guns. And then he went down and told all the crowd in Derby's Harbour he was after falling in love with this girl. Well, the girls down in Derby's Harbour, they were kind of short of men down there. So they didn't want Fergus to be tangled up with someone from another community. And so they made a plan to get him on the Berry Hills, where they proved his overthrow, according to Peter Leonard. So then Ferlin was compromised, and he had to marry one of them. And so the last verse tells us that Ferlin, he'll be married, and no more he'll have to roam, for he'll live in Derby's Harbour. That's the place he calls his home. Come all you Newfoundlanders, and I'll sing for ye a song all about a young man, and here he do belong. I sing foul the tall the dido, right foul the dee. He came from Derby's Harbour, he was very fond of sport, fell in love with a damsel, belonged to Pityford. I sing foul the tall the dido, right foul the dee. He courted her all summer now, as you may understand, and Hines he walked over for to see this young man. I sing fol-a-dol-a-dido, right fol-a-dee. Says Hines unto Ferlin, now me boy you needn't fret, if you marries Philomena, tis a house you'll surely get. I sing fol-a-dol-a-dido, right fol-a-dee. The old man Lake was listening, and nothing much he said, but he swore by his Redeemer, 'twould be better if you were dead. I sing fol-a-dol-a-dido, right fol-a-dee. Well, the wind blew from the eastern, and it blew a half a gale. Ferlin, he got ready, and he put aboard his sail. I sing fol-a-dol-a-dido, right fol-a-dee. He sailed her up to Pityford and landed on the shore. You're welcome, Mr. Dunphy, but your bed is on the floor. Rising fol-a-dol-a-dido, right fol-a-dee. He stayed with her till 3 o'clock, and they had a splendid time. Then he runned her back in paradise, sound to keep me song and rhyme. I sing fa-la-da-la-da-do, right, fa-la-dee. Straight up to Dunphy's now, and they were glad to hear all about the girl and the time that he had there. I sing fa-la-da-la-da-do, right, fa-la-dee. The women, they were listening, and nothing much they said, but they're thinking on those berry hills all night while they're in bed. I sing fa-la-da-la-da-do, right, fa-la-dee. Early in the morning, now the fog is very thick. If we had got a pilot, what berries would we pick? I sing fa-la-da-la-da-do, right, fa-la-dee. Well, Ferlin, he got ready, he had pluck enough to go. But when they got him on the hills, they proved his overthrow. I sing fa-la-da-la-da-do, right, fa-la-dee. So Ferlin, he'll be married now, no more he'll have to roam. He'll live in Derby's Harbour, that's the place he calls his home. I sing fa-la-da-la-da-do, 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 right, fa-la-dee. The sad story of poor old Ferlin. No, no, right fal-da-da-do has kind of gone right out of style. pick up a few oranges, yeah. Well, let's do a couple of Ron Hynes songs, okay? Maybe She Went Crazy and Liar. Actually, Maybe She Went Crazy is a song that Connie Hynes wrote with Ron about a relative of hers who had a few depression problems. And it, along with Liar, are on an album called 1111, which Sandy and I figured out today. It was recorded in 1997, so almost 25 years ago. But beautiful songs written by Connie Hynes, Connie Corkum from PEI, and her then husband, Ron Hynes. So let's sing those. Her time had taken a turn for the worse. One day's a blessing, one's a curse. So like a martyr to a state of grace, she disappeared without a trace. All anyone could say was that she simply went away. Years turned to yesterday's. I can remember when I was a child, her shining eyes and her sweet smile, till the night that she came home way past dark. What she brought home was a broken heart. Whatever had made the change had a face that she would never name. She wrote it down under lock and chain. Maybe she took a walk out across the sand, 'cause the pain would never end. She went all the way to the deepest end. Rumors abound, history's hazy. Maybe she went crazy. Maybe she went crazy. All anyone could say was that she simply went away. Years turned to yesterdays. Maybe she took a walk out across the sand, 'cause the pain would never end. She went all the way to the deepest end. Rumors abound, history's hazy. Maybe she went crazy. Maybe she went crazy. Ah, lovely chord. Maybe she went crazy. Now there were a number of singers. There were 11 singers on this album, and that one, that song was performed by Pamela Morgan on the piano, and it really is worth listening to. It's just beautiful. But this is the one that I sang for the album. And Boomer Stamp always called it, "I never met a lawyer my dog wouldn't bite." So if there are any lawyers in the audience, I do beg your forgiveness. Walk me to the corner when the moon is full. Tell me that you never seen any moon as beautiful as me. Never seen the stars shine so bright. I'm the one that you've been watching all night. Walk me out to where the lights are dim. Give me something to remember, to forget about him. Do anything, darling, I won't fight. I never met a liar that I didn't like. Dance me across the dance floor one more time, darling. Tell me everything that's going on in your mind. Every little thing you never could say to any other love you never could sway. Oh, whisper to me, I'm your heart's delight. I'm your heart's desire while the moon's on fire. Take me in your arms and hold me tight. I never met a liar that I didn't like. No, I never met a liar that I couldn't fall for, under any moon or over any dance floor. Walk me to the door beneath the neon light. Whisper to me everything is gonna be all right. Lead me up the long stairway to the door at the end of the long dark hallway. Don't be afraid, don't be ashamed. Ask anything, darling, but don't ask my name. Turn up the radio, turn down the light. I never met a liar that I didn't like. No, I never met a liar that I couldn't fall for, under any moon or over any dance floor. Don't be afraid, don't be ashamed. Ask anything, darling, but don't ask my name. Turn up the radio, turn down the light. I never met a liar that I didn't like. No, I never met a liar that I didn't fall for, under any moon or over any dance floor. That's really nice. And I remember I was at a gig one time when somebody, I think Ron sang it, and he said that he would give free beer to anyone who could recognize the Newfoundland place names in that song. Well, maybe we'll do the same during the intermission.
There are Newfoundland place songs in that song.
There are Newfoundland place names in that song. Two Newfoundland place names in that song. Not the Danforth, no. This is another Newfoundland place name. It's called Harbour Le Coo, down on the south coast. About a fellow who got up to no good, a married man who got up to no good when he was on the go down there. As I rowed ashore from my schooner close by, a girl on the beach I'd a chance to espy. Her hair it was red and her bonnet was blue, and her place of abode was in Harbour Le Coo. So boldly I asked her to walk on the sand. She smiled like an angel and held out her hand. So I button me Guernsey and I hove away me chew in the dark rolling waters of Harbour Le Coo. My ship she lay anchored far out on the tide, as I strolled along with this maid by me side. I told her I loved her and I said I'd be true, as I winked at the moon over Harbour Le Coo. As we strolled on the sands at the close of the day, I thought of me wife who was home in Torbay. I knew that she'd kill me if only she knew I was courting a lassie in Harbour Le Coo. Now we passed an old cabin that stood on the shore, where I met an old comrade I'd sailed with before. He treated me kindly, says, "Jack, how are you? It's so seldom we see you in Harbour Le Coo." Now as we were a-parting, this maiden in tow, he broke up me party with one single blow. Regards to your missus and wee kiddies too, I remember her well, she's from Harbour Le Coo. Well, I looked at this damsel standing alongside. Her jaw it did drop and her mouth opened wide. And then like a she-cat upon me she flew, and I fled from the furies of Harbour Le Coo. So come all ye young sailors who walk on the shore, be aware of those comrades you've sailed with before. Be aware of those maidens in their bonnets of blue, those pretty fair damsels of Harbour Le Coo. That's a nice little yarn, isn't it? Nice, sprightly little yarn there.
I winked at the moon.
I know.
And then like a she-cat.
I know. You have to watch out for them she-cats down on the south coast. And this is a song from Bonavista Bay. It was written in the 1800s by Mark Walker. Again, he's another fellow who... He didn't really read and write. He never went to school, but he was a great poet. And this song became a kind of, it's almost like a Newfoundland anthem, really. It's called Tickle Cove Pond. And when I sing this on the mainland, a lot of people are thinking, why is he singing a song about a dead horse? But I have to tell you that it's poetic exaggeration. The horse did not die. They got her out of the pond. They got her out of the pond in time before she died. So, here's the story of Kit in the pond. In cutting, in hauling, in frost and in snow, we're up against troubles that few people know. And it's only by patience and courage and grit and eating plain food can we keep ourselves fit. The hard and the easy we take as it comes. When ponds freeze over, we shorten our runs. Now to hurry me hauling, the spring coming on. Nearly lost me my mare on the Tickle Cove Pond. I knew that the ice became weaker each day, but I still took the risk and kept hauling away. One evening in April, bound home with a load, the mare showed some halting against the ice road. She knew more than I did as matters turned out. Lucky for me had I joined her in doubt. She turned round her head and with tears in her eyes, as if she were saying, "You're risking our lives." All this I ignored with a whip handle blow, for man is too stupid, dumb creatures to know. In the very next moment the pond gave a sigh, and down to our necks went poor Kitty and I. Now if I had taken wise Kitty's advice, I never would make that shortcut on the ice. Poor creature, she's dead, poor creature, she's gone, and I'll ne'er get my wood off the Tickle Cove pond. I raised an alarm you could hear for a mile, and neighbors turned up in a very short while. You can always rely on the Oldfords and Whites to render assistance in all your sad plights. To help a poor neighbor is part of their lives, the same I can say for their children and wives. When the rope, it was fastened around the mare's breast, William White for a shanty song made a request. There was no time for thinking, no time for delay. Straight from my head came these words right away. Lay hold, William Oldford, lay hold, William White. Lay hold to the bowl and then pull all your might. Lay hold to the bowl and then pull all you can, and give me a lift with poor kid on the pond. Lay hold, William Oldford, lay hold, William White. Lay hold of the hawser and pull all your might. Lay hold to the cordage and pull all you can. And with that, we got Kit out of Tickle Cove Pond. Tickle Cove Pond, Mark Walker from Sweet Bay in Bonavista Bay. Now we're going to hop to Branch for Riley the Fisherman. And Branch is a great spot down in St. Mary's Bay. There's another song that says, "To my surprise, I never saw a branch up in St. Mary's Bay." But that's a kind of a sad song. We won't sing that tonight. We'll sing about Riley the Fisherman, another sad song. It's high in body count.
We call them body count songs because, you know, sometimes albums have stars, like a five-star album. Well, some of the Newfoundland songs, so many people die that we had to start putting body bags.
Body bag icons. As I roved out one evening down by a riverside, I overheard a fair young maid, and the tears spilled from her eyes. It is a cruel and stormy night, these words I heard her say. My love is on the raging sea, bound for a merry cay. My love, he is a fisherman, his age is scarce 18. He's one of the finest young men that ever yet was seen. He's proper tall and handsome, most beautiful and fair. And there's not one in this country with him I would compare. John O'Reilly is my true love's name, reared near the town of Bray. My mama took me by the hand, these words to me did say, if you are fond of Riley, let him quit this country. Your father swears he'll take his life, so shun his company. Oh, mother dear, don't be severe. How can I leave my love? His very heart beats in his breast as constant as a dove. Oh, daughter dear, I'm not severe. Here is £1,000. Send Riley away to America to purchase there some ground. A very practical woman. When Ellen got the money to O'Reilly, she did run. This very night to take your life, my father charged a gun. Here is £1,000 in gold my mama sends to you. So sail away to America, and I will follow you. Sail away. It was scarcely 6 months after I was walking down the quay. O'Reilly, he's come back again to take his love away. But the boat was wrecked, all hands were lost. Her father grieved full sore. He found Riley in her arms, and they drowned up on the shore. He found a letter in her breast, and it was written blood. Cruel was my father, who thought to shoot my love. So let this be a warning to all fair maids, okay? Don't ever let the lad you love sail to America. Well, we're going to do just one more song in this set, and then we'll invite you to go out and refresh your drinks and maybe look at the CDs. We have a few CDs out there that you can purchase. And gosh, a long time ago now, Sandy and I started playing together kind of informally. We never had a band or anything on the go until Bristol's Hope. This was the first gig we played for a friend's wedding. And we thought we'd...
When was that?
Oh, God knows. It was in the 60s somewhere.
Lost in the 60s.
I can't remember it. Sandy is fond of saying, if you can remember the 60s, you weren't there.
I say that about the 70s too.
So thank you all for coming out. It's great to know that you're there. There are places I'll remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some are gone and some remain. All these places had their moments with lovers and friends I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. In my life, I love you more. Thank you. See you in a little while. I'm used to more rowdy people than my. We're going to start with a song. I love to sing the French songs from the Port au Port because, you know, not many people sing them anymore. And for a long time, they lost their language down there because when they went to school, the teachers would smack them on the hands for speaking French. They wanted them to assimilate. And
our crowd used to smack us on the hands for not being able to speak French.
Well, there you go. There you go. But anyway, they did persist, and now, of course, with the help of the Canadian government and everything, they have French schools down there, and there's a whole French school network across the province. And this is a song about a girl, and it's kind of slightly risque, but you'll only understand it if you're French, so if there's any youngsters here, don't worry about that. It's about a girl who was... it's sort of a play on words, the whole song, and it's about a girl who was by a fountain, like a bird bath kind of thing, and she's crying away, and so on comes this regiment of soldiers, and they ask her name and what's wrong with her and all that, and she's, do you know, it took an entire regiment of soldiers to sort out this poor girl's sorrows.
Was it Barry season by any chance?
It was berry season, I think, in France, on the road to Dijon, where they make the mustard.
Ah, mustard season.
Sur la route de Dijon, ma belle digadig, ma belle digadon. Sur la route de Dijon, ma belle digadig, ma belle digadon. Il y avait une fontaine, digadon, digadon, daine. Il y avait une fontaine aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. Près d'elle une jolie tendron, la belle digidig, la belle digidon. Près d'elle une jolie tendron, la belle digidig, ma belle digidon. Pleurer comme une madeleine, digidon, digidon, daine. Pleurer comme une madeleine, aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. Par le passe un bataillon, la belle digidig, la belle digidon. Par le passe un bataillon, la belle digidig, la belle digidon. Qui chantait à perdre haleine, digidon, digidon, daine. Qui chantait à perdre haleine, aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. Comment vous nomme-t-on, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon? Comment vous nomme-t-on, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon? Je me nomme Marjolaine, digidon, digidon, daine. Je me nomme Marjolaine, aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. Marjolaine qu'avez-vous donc, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon? Marjolaine qu'avez-vous donc, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon? Oh, messieurs, j'ai tant de peine, digidon, digidon, d'aine. Oh, messieurs, j'ai tant de peine, aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. Paraît que tout le bataillon, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon. Paraît que tout le bataillon, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon. Consola la Marjolaine, digidon, digidon, d'aine. Consola ma Marjolaine, aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. Si vous passez à Dijon, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon. Si vous passez à Dijon, ma belle digidig, ma belle digidon. Allez boire à la fontaine, digidon, digidon, d'aine. Allez boire à la fontaine, aux oiseaux, aux oiseaux. And now another little funny up song. It's called... It is called Moonshine Can, and it comes from the Northern Peninsula. I have a drop of water here. Come all you moonshine drinkers, and ye will plainly see the work of the bold informers and the way they treated me. I'll tell of the bold informers who've lately been around. They jealously could not agree and they put me moonshine down. Easter Sunday morning and down the road I see Mickey waving both his arms and heading straight for me. He waved his arms and called aloud as down the road he ran, "Pat me boy, there's an awful kick about your moonshine can." Next there came a summons to tell me I must go. They made me walk that lonesome trail up to me knees in snow. Made me walk that lonesome trail and they put me on the stand. "Pat me boy, you'll have to pay for running a moonshine can." I'd like to know how moonshine's made, the magistrate did say. "East cake and molasses, now that's the proper way. East cake and molasses, now that's the cutest plan." The magistrate was happy then, he took me moonshine can. Here's to that good magistrate, God bless his eyes of blue. He sent me home with a constable and told him what to do. When they broke me moonshine can, it nearly burst my heart. But when they fired it into the bay, it tore me soul apart. Here's to that good magistrate, may the Lord receive me friend. When he dies, we'll bury him and he'll go to the other end. St. Peter then will greet him and the gate he will unlock. Come right in, good magistrate, you're welcome to the flock. Now here's to the man who wrote this song, I'm sure he was not lying. If you want to know his name is Paddy Troy. His name is Paddy Troy, me boys, and Goose Cove he belong. When the moonshine time comes round again, he'll make her twice as strong. Here's to the moonshine can. I think it's a savior now. Yeah. It really is, really is. Not too great on the old body either. I'll sing a couple of Ron Hines songs for you. Well, the first one's called Savior. And it's kind of nice, you don't hear it very much, but it's on our CD. And it talks about the human spirit, the strength of the human spirit. And you can join me on the na-nas, right? It's a really simple chorus. There's only one word in it, a na. na 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 to everything there is a first time for every song there is a right rhyme even tiny dreams come at a great cost just as every gain arrives with great loss behind each truth there hides a lie so sweet beyond each trust lurks the heart of jealousy where goes the cross there goes the carrier and to every lost soul there comes a savior here we are in time when all things shall be known here we are in space beyond the blazing sun spirits of steel in shells so fragile old as the hills and yet a small child na 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 to everything there is that first time for every song there is that right rhyme even tiny dreams come at a great cost just as every gain arrives with great loss behind each truth there hides a lie so sweet beyond each trust lurks a heart of jealousy where goes the cross there goes the carrier and to every lost soul there comes a savior here we are in time when all things shall be known here we are in space beyond the blazing sun spirits of steel in shells so fragile old as the hills and yet a small child na 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 come on na 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 Savior Ron Hives and away
Ron is our greatest lyricist
I know.
That's probably his greatest lyric now.
He was a great lyricist.
I mean, he was an educated poet. You know what I'm saying?
He was. He went to school. He went to school. But he wrote some amazing songs, and we always like to do a few every concert, just to remind people. Well, he left us far too early, but there you go. This is about leaving, going away. Well, I remember the morning that I sailed away. Turning one last time, I blew a kiss to her. She smiled at me from the cold edge of the water. I turned my face to the wind and the tears followed. Last night I dreamed that I lay beside her clinging to her like a child to his mother. When I awoke, the cold lay claim to my heart. Knowing full well as I whispered her name, I never would smile upon her sweet face again. Well, I remember the morning that I sailed away. Away, Van Hines. A La Claire Fontaine. This is another song from down on the West Coast. This reminds me of Sandy, this song, because it talks about a fellow sees a nice little body of water, decides to go for a swim. And if you follow Sandy's Facebook page, you'll know that he swims in every body of water he can find. À la claire fontaine, m'en allant promener, j'ai trouvé l'eau si belle que je m'y suis baignée. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. J'ai trouvé l'eau si belle que je m'y suis baigné sur la plus haute branche, un rossignol chantait. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Sur la plus haute branche, un rossignol chantait, chante, rossignol chante, toi qui as le cœur gai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Chante, rossignol, chante, toi qui as le cœur gai, tu as le cœur à rire, moi je l'ai à pleurer. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Tu as le cœur à rire, moi je l'ai à pleurer. J'ai perdu ma maîtresse sans l'avoir méritée. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. J'ai perdu ma maîtresse sans l'avoir méritée pour un bouquet de roses que je lui refusais. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Pour un bouquet de roses que je lui refusais, je voudrais que la rose fût encore au rosier. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Je voudrais que la rose fût encore au rosier, et moi et ma maîtresse dans les mêmes amitiés. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. Il y a longtemps que je t'aime, jamais je ne t'oublierai. And now we have a Johnny Burke song. You may talk of Clara Nolan's ball. Now, Johnny Burke wrote this song, and it was almost an in-joke, really, because there's a lot of stuff mentioned in it that the people in St. John's would have been familiar with, and nobody else would have been familiar with. He wrote various versions of it. There was all kinds of versions of it. He started writing it in 1904, and he finished it off, I think, in 1912 or something. He had it published down in the United States. And so he put in a bunch of references to what was going on in the United States at the time. Wilson, Taft, and Teddy Roosevelt, were from running in the elections down there at the time. And Johnson, champion of the ring, was actually the bare-knuckle champion of the United States at the time. And Clara Nolan, everyone was wondering who Clara Nolan was. Well, she was a New York socialite that was known for the parties she used to throw. So he put all these references in the hopes that people would buy the song and make him rich. I don't think it happened. It's very rare that people get rich on songs, but sometimes it happens. You may talk of Clara Nolan's ball or anything you choose, but it couldn't hold a snuffbox to the spree of Kellagrews. If you want your eyeballs straightened, come out next week with me. You'll have to wear your glasses at the Kellagrew soiree, cause there was birch rind, tart wine, cherry wine and turpentine, jowls and cavalances, ginger beer and tea. Pig's feet, cat's meat, dumplings boiled up in a sheet, dandelions and cracky teeth at the Kellagrew soiree. Well, I bore Clooney's beaver hat as I squared me yards to sail, with a swallowtail from Hogan that was foxy on the tail. Billy Cudahy's old working pants and Patsy Nolan's shoes, an old white vest from Fogarty to sport at Kellagrew's, where there was Dan Milly, Joe Lilly, Tan Tan and Mrs. Tilly dancing like a little filly. It would raise your heart to see Jim Bryan, Din Ryan, Flipper Smith and Caroline. I'll tell you, boys, we had a time at the Kellagrew soiree. Now, when I arrived at Betsy Snooks that night at 8:30, the place was blocked with carriages stood waiting at the gate. With Clooney's funnel upon me pate, the first words Betsy said, here comes the local preacher with the pulpit on his head. And there was Bill Mews, Dan Hughes, Wilson Taft and Teddy Roos. Brian, he sat in the blues and looking hard at me. Jim Fling, Tom King, Johnson, champion of the ring, and all the boxers I could bring to the Kellagrew soiree. Well, the Saratoga Lancers first, Miss Betsy kindly said, sure I'd dance with Nancy Cronin and her granny on the head. And couldn't Hogan dance with Betsy? Well, he should have seen his shoes as he lashed the muskets from the rack that night at Kellagrew's. And there was boiled guineas, cool guineas, bullocks' heads and pickaninnies, everything to catch the penny should crack your sides to see. Bald off and figgy off, and apple jam was in a cough, and I'll tell you, boys, we had enough at the Kellagrew soiree. Well, Crooked Flavin struck the fiddler, so a hand I then took in. You should see George Clooney's beaver hatting it flattened to the rim. Hogan's coat was like a vest, the tails were gone, you see. Says I, the devil haul ye in your Kellagrew soiree. The Kellagrew Soiree by Johnny Burke. And for those of you who get the Newfoundland place names in Lyre, it's Heart's Delight and Heart's Desire, the two Newfoundland place names. And this is another Newfoundland place name, Pat Murphy's Meadow. You've been in Pat Murphy's Meadow.
I have been to Pat Murphy's Meadow. It's quite a big meadow.
Yeah?
It is, yeah. I wouldn't want to have
mowed. Well, somebody mowed it. It's down in King's Cove. And J.M. Devine, who used to have a business in St. John's, remember it was called the Big Six. It was down on Water Street. And the old radio ads used to say, the Big Six. This program is brought to you by the Big Six. Once a number, now an institution.
And Kingscote is the Athens of the North.
The Athens of the North, yes.
How did they get back
there? I don't, maybe a lot of Greek people lived there? No, no. No, actually, it was called that because everybody was educated in King's Cove. They loved to go to school out there. And, yeah, they were all an educated bunch who liked to read. That's where Marjorie Doyle lives now, right?
Yes.
She has a summer home out there.
There's a Gerald F. Doyle Museum there. They had a little swimming pool right next to
it. Yeah. Well, Gerald S. Doyle, who collected a lot of songs himself, is Marjorie's father, and he, you know, he did a tremendous service to the people of Newfoundland by way of selling his drugs. He printed a songbook, many versions of it. Actually, I think there are about 10 issues, 10 editions of it that came out, and almost every household in Newfoundland had a copy of these songs that he had gone around and gotten from people and collected from people. And sometimes the music was there, but mostly not, because people already knew the tunes to these songs, and he was just providing them with the words. So the Gerald S. Doyle songbook's great.
He's the only drug dealer that ever published a songbook.
Is that?
We know.
I don't know that many drug dealers myself, apart from Shoppers Drug Mart. So here's Pat Murphy's Meadow. It might be the wrong time of the year, but we're going to sing it anyway. Yes, but they say the autumn days are here again. The wind does chilly blow. Not the wind hasn't been chilly blowing the past couple of days, I can tell you. The autumn days are here again. The night winds chilly blow. The woodland turns to golden hue, and the harvest moon's aglow. I think again of days gone past, to come no more I know. When I mowed Pat Murphy's meadow in the sunny long ago, I see the blue of ocean and the distant sails afar, and the maiden in the meadow as she strikes up Lochinvar. There's music in the soft touch of that wind that whispered low. When I mowed Pat Murphy's meadow in the sunny long ago. Where are the boys and girls now who danced in the gay quadrilles, or the singers warbling sweetly, or the burning granite mills? Just to hear again at sunset where sweet Afton's waters flow. When I mowed Pat Murphy's meadow in the sunny long ago. Those days are but a memory now, like the ghost snows of yesteryear. And when evening shades are falling, all alone shed a tear. On my cheek I feel the soft kiss of that wind that whispered low. When I mowed Pat Murphy's meadow in the sunny long ago. And now, what have I got?
Where would we be without a phone?
I think it's time for a Johnny Cash song.
Oh, lovely.
You can all sing along with this one.
Okay.
At my door, the leaves are falling. The cold, wild wind will come. Sweethearts walk by together, but I still miss someone. I go out on a party and look for a little fun. I find a darkened corner 'cause I still miss someone. No, I never got over those blue eyes. I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held me when all the love was there. I wonder if he's sorry for leaving what we begun. There's someone for me somewhere, but I still miss someone. No, I never got over those blue eyes. I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held me when all the love was there. I wonder if he's sorry for leaving what we'd begun. There's someone for me somewhere, but I still miss someone. I still miss someone. I never got over those blue eyes.
That's
a good one. And we're doing fifth, huh?
Well, thank you so much for coming out. It's been great to sing for you, even though I can't see you very much unless I really squint. But I'll see you afterwards. And Sandy and I are really thrilled to be back performing again and instead of being on Zoom all the time.
Well, honestly, that was the first time I've ever felt colder inside than out.
We're going to sing a song by Jack Withers, a song that we came up with an arrangement for. It's a song about going to the Labrador, fishing all summer and coming back to the East Coast of Newfoundland, particularly. Passing along by Baccalieu Island, wind sprang up and the boat almost went aground. It's called The Cliffs of Baccalieu, and he wrote it for a radio show, actually. And since I'm a volunteer with VOBB Radio, Community Radio, I love songs that, you know, are written for radio shows. And Sandy and I just recorded one for a radio show that David Ferry is putting on next week at the Writers.
Fake radio show. Not this year.
It's a faux radio show. Anyway, it's a great song called The Cliffs of Baccalieu. We were bound home in October from the shores of Labrador, trying to race a bold nor'easter and snow too. But the wind swept down upon us, making day as dark as night.
just before we made the land at Bagaloo. Well, we tried to clear the island as we brought her further south, but wind from both the nor'east stronger blew, and our lookout soon he shouted for their right dead ahead. Through the snow squalls loomed the cliffs of Bagaloo, and it was hard down with the tiller as we struggled with the sheets, trying our best to haul them in a foot or two. And our deck so sharply tilted, we could scarcely feel our feet as we struggled on the rocks at Bagaloo. Well, the combers beat her under, and I thought she'd never rise, and her main boom was bending nigh in two, and all hands clung to windward as they stared with straining eyes down to leeward at the cliffs of Bagaloo. For to leeward was the island, and to windward was the gale, and the blinding sleet had cut you through and through. Oh, with her lee rail 3 foot under and 2 hands at the wheel, we hauled her from the cliffs of Bagaloo. Yes, we hauled her to the southern, and her canvas stood the strain, and the blinding snow squalls from the northeast flew. But our hearts were beaten gladly when no longer could we gaze down to leeward at the cliffs Bagaloo.
Thank you so much, and thank you for coming out. Thank you to David, and thank you to Brad for doing the sound. It was lovely.
And that's it. Let's take a bow.
Thank you.
I can't find any words to it.
I gotta tune all the drum out of this thing, huh?
God knows what we're gonna do.
What are you gonna do?
How about Jim Reeves?
For what?
Remember Jim Reeves and Lefty Frizzell?
Four songs. Jim Reeves was like God.
The strings are going on the guitar. Yeah.
Like a little bit of Latin.
A little bit of Latin. Is that the right key?
Oh, no, sorry.
Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you he'll have to go. Whisper to me, tell me, do you love me, do? Or is he holding you the way I do? Though love is blind, make up your mind, I have to know. Should I hang up, or will you tell him he'll have to go? You can't say the words I want to hear while you're with another man. Yeah, do you love me? Answer yes or no. Maybe I will understand. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you he'll have to go. Can't say the words I want to hear while you're with another man. Do you love me? Answer yes or no. Darling, I will understand. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you he'll have to go. And you can tell your friend there with you he'll have to go. Thank you very much. And now we gotta go. Thank you very much for coming out.